Hello. So, we adopted the dog we wanted on Saturday, and as I was taking him to the house, he escaped his leash and ran into the woods. Which is why I haven't been back on, because I've been devoting 110% of my efforts to finding him, but we just started getting some sightings of him today, so we're hopeful that we can bring him back. He's still in the area. I'm cooking bacon all day in the back. We have a trap set up and baited with some McDonald's. We're just hoping to get him back. But I haven't felt like doing any of this stuff. But I saw him this morning. I know he's alive. I know he hasn't been stolen. The nauseous feeling in the pit of my stomach has slightly abated. So I thought I would come do this to pass some time because he's very skittish and me chasing him isn't going to help anything. We're basically counting on him to want to go after the McDonald's in the trap in our yard. I don't know how much tev work I'm gonna do, but I'm pretty preoccupied. I feel like my life can't really resume until I solve this issue. I can't derive enjoyment from anything while this poor dog that I caused to be lost is still out there. Hey, Flatnum. So, I adopted a dog on Saturday, and we were taking him in the house after driving for 5 hours to go pick him up 2.5 hours and 2.5 hours back to bring him back. I was taking him out of the car, and I made the decision, which was a bad decision, to let him pee in our yard before I took him in, and he slipped his leash and ran into the woods. That's why I haven't been on. I've been given 110% of my efforts to that search. But we got the first hopeful news this morning. I saw him in the park. He went back in the woods. He's very skittish. I saw him in the park. And then someone saw him on our street after he went in the woods. So we know he's in the area. We have a trap baited with a bunch of McDonald's. And we have we've put a bunch of liquid smoke in the yard to make it smell like a barbecue. I'm cooking bacon. I got 6 pounds of bacon on the grill in the back that I'm just gonna cook till it's a charred crisp. Just to put the smell out. Try to attract him out, but I've just been like absolutely gutted over this for the past several days. But just seeing him made me like have a little bit of hope because now I know he's alive, I know he hasn't been stolen or killed or injured. So I'm not sure how much of dev work I'm gonna do today. But I just like that. I don't think there's much else I can do right now other than just like waiting and hoping he smells the McDonald's and goes in the trap. So I logged on. I figured I'd do a little bit to try and pass some time. Here in about an hour, I'm gonna go get some more McDonald's to put it in there. I feel this is the worst I've ever felt, I think, about anything. Like even when my dog Charlie died from brain cancer, it wasn't my fault. And I mean, like, I had no hope because he's a 9-month-old dog. He's not familiar with the area or us. So I just assumed, like, we're never gonna see him again. Like, he's gone. He's gone so far away, I'm never gonna see him. But I saw him today. He's still on our street. There's a big thing of woods behind our street that I think he's using as a base of operations to kind of poke in and out of. To get food and such. So it gives me a lot more hope. I'm not the kind of person to put a lot of stock in hope. I always thought hope itself by itself is useless unless it's coupled with action. I still believe that because I've been busting ass for the past several days trying to resolve this. Just absolutely, like, I've gotten more exercise in the past 3 days than I probably have in years. But I was able to see him. Oh my gosh, he was such a sweet dog too. Like in the whole car ride back, he just sat in my lap. I don't know what spooked him when I was trying to walk him in the yard. But like we had put him in a harness that had always worked for my other dog, which is a similar size. He never pulled out of it or anything like that. But this dog, he just did like a little back scoot maneuver and he slipped right out of it. It's like one of those harnesses that goes around the neck and legs. He like scrunched up his front paws forward in front of him like Superman style and just like scooted backwards and slipped right out of it and he was off into the woods. I tried to chase him, which was the wrong thing to do now, I realize. But I tried to chase him. I was crashing through this densely wooded area with thorns and fucking poison ivy and poison oak. I didn't give a fuck. So I got all scratched up. Luckily, so I was never allergic to poison ivy or oak when I was a kid, and it would appear that that is still holding true because I haven't broken out in any rashes, which is kind of strange because I'm super allergic to like many different types of cloth detergents. To the point where, like, we swapped cloth detergents one time. My entire body, like, probably 75% of my body broke out in a rash. It was absolutely miserable experience. But then, poison ivy and poison oak don't do anything. But yeah, I didn't think he would escape when I took him out because he was so chill and sweet in the car. He was just absolute, like, he was on my lap the whole drive, just chilling on my lap. Very chill, super great, kind dog, gentle, not really barky, not overexcited. And at 9 months old, to be able to do that is really impressive. So I just assumed he was going to be like calm tempered. And I put him on the leash, and I was like, okay, well, it's been a, 3 hour car ride. I'm gonna take him back inside. And I think a car drove by that might have spooked him. And he just did that little back scoot maneuver, flipped around, did a 180, and tore off across the road. And I tore off after him, which I think was the wrong thing to do, but I didn't know that at the time. I do now because, like, obviously you do shitloads of research on, like, what am I doing when my dog's lost type shit, you know? And they say not to chase them because it panics them, but I didn't know that. I was just, like, panicking, basically. And he escaped into the woods, but it looks like he's stayed in this general area, which is, I'm so happy because, like, being able to just narrow the search down, know he's alive, know he's not stolen, and know he's still like in the local area. I feel like we'll get him back now. I didn't feel like we'd get him back before today, before I saw him. I felt like I'd fucked up and destroyed this wonderful dog that was beloved by his foster mother that I adopted him from. And through like a 1 second mistake, just like it's one of those inflection points where you just see the future shift in an instant. It's like he was taking a pee in the yard. He's about to go inside and have a super loving home. And then he slipped his leash, and like all these bad endings start cropping up in the future. Like anything could happen now. My dad's calling me, so I'm gonna mute. Actually, I don't have any signal down here, so I'll call him in a minute. Oh, so the last thing I was doing over here was making a luminous gas planet, potentially luminous gas planet. As like a rare type. Which I can do with this master material I've made. So I don't know if you saw this, but I have this material. It can take a temperature gradient, a luminous gradient. I'm pretty sure you saw the temperature. I added this luminous gradient to do like lava planets. You might have seen that. It can have a Fresnel, which is what makes it look like a gas planet. It's just a Fresnel mask. You have all these basically randomization coefficients, and then you have all these randomization coefficients. So if you recall a while back, I was feeding in like X offsets and pans and all that shit, but now I feed them in as vectors because I have three textures that I need to do it to. So I just, each one of these represents different X offsets for each texture of each color. And it's a lot easier to do it like this. You can also randomize it as a color if you want to randomize a vector. You don't have to do it one by one. These would be pans. No, these are offsets. Up here was pans, which is why it's panning. So I'm gonna go call my dad. I'll be back.
All right. Got a few minutes. Oh, God, where even was I? Shit.
I think I need to make my planet generator now. I have my... Oh, yeah, here we go. So... with planet parameters in a random stream, I'm gonna have to make a ring, a planet ring, but I can leave it for now. And I'm gonna have to make an atmosphere, but I can also leave that for now. This picks the material for the planet based on its type. This sets all my offsets. So, actors. Actor component. All right. Okay, so now I'm gonna have to figure out how to this randomizes everything, and then here I need to here. Location change, I think I need. Just thinking, because this is going to be really fundamental. So, like, my head is so clouded and so difficult to think. So two things have to happen here. This has to notify BB star. Delete. Let's go to the star. Okay. Thinking. This.
on event, it's gonna take plenty of parameters. Array.
Crazy idea. What if I made the planet parameters a map? And their key was the orbit distance. Nah, I already have orbit distance in the planet parameter. It can just be an array. That's fine. There's parameters. Random stream. Yeah, there we go. Oh, I don't need the random stream here. Hold on. Is all I need to do? Okay, I need to look at whatever author over here. Yeah, there we go. Location. Okay, yeah. I don't gotta do shit. I just gotta, for each array element, pass this here. And then I need beep, beep. At least I set myself in a good spot when I stopped. Clean up after ourselves. And then we can come here. Persistent level. Come back here. Let's bring that in a bit. Okay, so it didn't work. These. Okay, so it did some stuff. Do I have a directional light in the scene? I do.
Let's go inside the star. Maybe I made the star too big. It is quite big. Not seeing any planets. So where are they? Oh, you know what? I didn't put the same brightening logic. I have to put the planets have to get brighter the further away I am from them until they're glimmering like little stars, and then you can see them. Maybe. The other thing I could do is just go back in here, reduce this number again. Spawn planets. It says it did. I guess I could start it and just look at the planet stats. Location, rotation, scale. Okay, I know it's up. Stop. And then here, and this is going to be a little different. So we need to break this. Rotation angle. So we make a vector. Out of the min max distances. Multiplied by some value. That gives us our distance. Then we rotate that based on the orbit angle. And then that goes in here. Look at this. We rotate it on the Z by the rotation angle. Goes in here. And then, oops. And then, okay, gonna need this again. Copy. Need this and this. Sure, we can make that visible. All right, and now size class multipliers matches up to this here and that. It's multiplied by the radius and multiplied again by that, and then this goes in here. Four, six, I'll try 4 million. Size multiplier gotta go way, 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 way up for me to be able to see these guys. Big are we now? 12,000. That should be visible. Somewhere. Alright. What if I make... Yep. Okay. It did at least do something. Give me a little planet. Do I plonk into it? Nope. Alright, and the planet's big enough. Oh, I think I just locked up. No. Still good. So where are the other ones? Out in the void of space? Unlit? Nope. There they are. Alright. So, what is working and what is not? Orbit rotation is not working. Setting the materials up is not working. A lot of things are not working, but it is spawning planets. It should just be spawning them much, much further away from each other. Alright, so if I did planet size unit... too big. Save that. Empty planet spawner, we need to add a variable here. It's going to be max orbit. Gonna be a float. Gonna be visible. Gonna be single. Its value is gonna be. Value's gonna be 80. No, it's too big. 40 million. Extremely far away now. Idea. What if I change this. Where did my player start? Gotta do, it is rotating them, but not the way that I want it to. So like, stop this guy. Wait. Radiant vector on axis, angle in degrees is this. This is why they're only slightly offset. Look at that. Alright, let's go to a planet. On a voyage.
I really should rig up the keybind for warp before I did this. I think this one's actually closer. It's just very small. That's like a super planet over there. This is progress. They don't even look that bad from a distance. I'll add a little bit of glow to them. This is supposed to be a gas planet. It has the Fresno effect, I think. Maybe not. Maybe it's just that I haven't done any lighting passes or anything. No, it does have the Fresno because you can see through it. Oh man, the sun looks really good from here. Alright. This is pretty sick, actually. Okay. That's going to be my stopping point. I'm going to go get some more McDonald's for the trap.